I mean, we saw Mars Volta play a concert in LA when we were, it was one of their first concerts actually, it was amazing. Yeah, they had a few extra musicians playing with them, a keyboard player and a percussion player and stuff, and yeah, it was amazing, crazy. Yeah, for sure, yeah, sort of strange modern prog rock, you know, it was pretty cool. Yeah, I think Muse is, I think we're trying to make music that tries to encompass as much as possible all of the knowledge you've ever had, whether it be spiritual knowledge, emotional experience, life experience, relationships, musical knowledge, musical influences, feelings about the world, feelings about politics, feelings about everything. And I think we try and put all of that into one album, if possible. Yeah, of course. Well, I think as long as you're changing it yourself, as long as I think the music we make is very much a personal expression. And I think that so far the journey has been more of a personal journey as opposed to just a musical journey. Do you know what I mean? As long as our lives are changing and new things are happening, then the music will always be changing as well. For me, it's the kind of thing that when you hear it, it makes you just not afraid of dying at all. I think that music can have that effect sometimes. So not necessarily the music we make, but the music that I listen to from other people. I think you can get that from two different types. You can get it from music like bands like Flaming Lips, who do really uplifting kind of stuff, or even classical music, which has some kind of feeling in it that I can't explain through words, but it's kind of a feeling of something that goes beyond our time. But also just the hard rock sort of animal instinct of survival that you get from more aggressive music. And I think trying to find a mix between the two is like the overall conclusion of what life is. You know, I don't know if I'm different to other people or not. I have difficulty working it out. I sometimes think that I'm very similar to other people in the sense that this living in modern society is quite unusual, I think, because there's no clear goal and there's no clear reason for anything. And I think that's because of the loss of all religious hope and the kind of materialistic way of life. So I think it's difficult to find meaning in life. And I think that's probably the reason why I spend so much time thinking about if there is any meaning or what if there is, if there isn't or there is. And I think that it can be the source of, probably when I was younger, the source of some kind of bad feeling about life or some kind of depression or something. But I think the act of making music is like the solution for me. You know, that is my meaning. That's what gives meaning. Because it's like collecting all of the mixed stuff, the stuff that you hate, the stuff that you love, mixing it all together in one song or one album. And the process of doing that is, for some reason, makes it have meaning. I don't know. I think it's getting to the point where I'm thinking about making music that, I mean, I when I listen back to a lot of classical composers, a lot of them, they're making music in order to try to directly communicate with God. And I think that's something that people don't really, I mean, I don't really believe in God so much now, but I think it's getting to the point where I'm trying to make music not even for myself and not really for people anymore. I think I'm just trying to make music as some kind of, to bridge the gap between reality and what if there is anything else outside of that for myself. It's not necessarily my intention to do that for other people, because other people will have their own opinion of what it is. You know, some people think it's shit, or some people think that it has no meaning, or some people think it's very important or whatever. But I think for me, the act of making music is almost a way of trying to discover if there is God. I don't really maintain any boundaries. I think some songs on the album are they stay within very obvious rock arrangements. I think there's other songs that go beyond the boundary of what is acceptable in everyday thinking. I think there's songs like Apocalypse Please or Butterflies and Hurricanes, Blackout, these kind of songs that delve into the kind of the more extreme elements of fear or panic and exaggerated emotion or whatever, which is a part of me, so therefore it is an expression, but at the same time I suppose it's a part of me that I don't talk about in everyday life, or I don't really express in everyday life. Yeah, I think the boundaries, some songs, they automatically have their own boundaries because they deal with very simple things, but I think it's important if there's a certain song or a certain feeling that feels like it goes outside of your own understanding, I think that again comes across in the music. I think it's a combination of the two, really. I think there's boundaries that we've established on previous albums that we've, like, certain a style of music kind of learnt that we do, that we've enhanced again on some songs on this album. So there are some songs that obviously are references to previous albums. I think that they're kind of, you know, paradigms that we've already established. But I think that at the same time, there's definitely a few songs that are completely in randomly newer areas. And I think whenever you go into new areas, then obviously you're delving into the unknown, and that's where you can make big mistakes, or you can actually come up with some completely new thing that changes your perception of how to make music. So I think that this album is a balance between the two. I think there's probably 50% stuff that we've established that we know we can do, and we know that we can do well. And I think the other half is kind of stuff that we've never done before, and it probably won't be clear how good it is for another year or something. I try not to think like that. I mean, I think I can always the songs, the only failure I think is when you record songs too quickly and then you go and play them live for about 6 months or a year and they change so much that they are 10 times better than when you recorded them. But I can't really see that. I mean, it's a failure, but it's also a limit of time, a limit of, you know, the limit of being alive in itself. So, I mean, you can't hold all of your songs and work on them for years before you record them. There's a few songs on sort of previous albums that I feel that if you recorded them sort of 6 months later than we did record them, they would have been much, much better. I mean, but at the same time, you know, you have to move on. So, if you talk about personal failure, I think that. I mean, failure in terms of outside, like critics or people or whatever. That's something I that wouldn't really change me. I think there's only so much you can do in one life. You know what I mean? I think you've got to try and do as much as you can. If you are a person that likes creating, anyway, I think that it's you do feel the limits of time maybe in because as your understanding is growing, you kind of realise that you don't ever really want to stop that growth. You know, and it's difficult. I don't know. I think I haven't really thought too much about failure. I think I'm a relatively positive thinker when it comes to making music. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, but I think at the same time, I think failure is something in retrospect. You know, it's something you look back on maybe years later and think that that was very wrong. But the fact that it was in the past means that you can't change it. And it's I suppose all you can do is try to move on. At the same time, I don't think we ever truly do what I really want to do, and that is make music that will probably be more important than my own life. Do you know what I mean? But I think that's something that's very, very difficult to do. I think that only a few kind of, it's difficult to say in the last 50 years which bands or which groups or which artists will be remembered in hundreds of years. It's not my intention necessarily to be remembered, but I think the intention is to make music that is still relevant after your own death. Do you know what I mean? So I think that's a kind of, maybe some kind of insecurity with facing death maybe, or something like that. But therefore making music is a way of not being scared of dying, I think, because it makes you feel there is at least something that you've done that is going to stay with some people, even if it's just one person or whatever, after you've gone. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's definitely a good reason to live. I can't imagine stopping. I mean, there's loads of other areas I'm interested in music. I think that you know, I've been working very much in kind of the rock world, but I think there's other things I'm interested in that I'm sure that I'd still be doing when I'm old. You know, so I don't really think that we're that complex. You know, I think there's definitely other artists out there that are making music that is more difficult, much more difficult to understand the intention or the reason. I think there's moments where we're actually trying to simplify certain feelings into a way that you can instantly relate to. I suppose there is moments of where we are trying to go for music that's a little bit more profound than the obvious. I don't know. I'm not sure where it will go. I mean, to me, like listening to a lot of classical music, for example, that's so profound that I cannot explain it. You know what I mean? Because it's so, I mean, and it has to be, because it's lasted hundreds of years, and it has to have some pure truth about the human experience that goes beyond fashion and goes beyond life. And I think that's probably the reason why that music's lasted so long. And I think that, so when I listen to that, I mean, at the same time, it's extremely complex, and it takes unbelievable mathematical and spiritual understanding to create that kind of music. But at the same time, I think you can just listen to it and drift off into a dream that ever goes. I don't think that music goes beyond people's understanding. I think to try to explain it from a critical point of view becomes very, very difficult, maybe. I'm talking about classical music. I don't think that stops people from getting something from it, you know. I don't know, because I think in modern days, I mean, with recording technology, obviously, you can create masses of sound with just electronica. I think that electronica is obviously an area that you can create things, but at the same time, I think that something has been lost that used to be there in getting large groups of people to play together. That if you can get a large group of people to play in harmony together in some all together for one piece of music, then that is from the person who is watching. I think they get something. They get a kind of positive feeling for life that you don't get from pure electronica. I think electronica can take you somewhere interesting, but I think it stays within the realm of our modern time. I don't know. I think I'm interested in both areas, really. I think I'm interested in the conflicts between things, like in particular, you know, the conflict between hard rock, aggressive, nihilistic music against spiritual, intelligent music. I mean, I think that kind of conflict between those two, the fact that I like both things, is I'm kind of interested in how they both if it's possible to mix them together. But in terms of the orchestra and stuff, I think we did do two songs, and those two songs were very suitable for that, because they had the kind of lyrics and the kind of the arrangement and everything was very worked very, very well. But there's other songs we had on the album that you just couldn't have an orchestra on, because it would just sound stupid. So I don't know, I suppose unless we create like loads and loads of songs that have the requirement for large choirs or large orchestras, which I, again, that's something I really would like to do, but again, it's so expensive, I don't know. We'll see, I mean, because it's quite sad to do that but not be able to tour with it, you know. I think it's definitely something I'd like to do at some point in the future, but I think I'd probably wait until we get to a point where we know that we can tour like that, you know. So, yeah, exactly, yeah. Some solo artists, they have much bigger budgets behind them to make stuff, so because it's accepted that they are not a band, they are a solo artist, so they need the extra artists, you know, to work with. But yeah, something I'm interested in. Well, I mean, everyone's stuck within something, you know. I mean, you can never be truly free in anything to do with life. I mean, you can look for it and try and strive for it, but I mean, you know, you can be constrained by your physical abilities, you can be constrained by your personal life, you can be constrained by money, you can be constrained by religious belief or anything. I think that, or you can be constrained by the government, which is the most common thing, I suppose, or constrained by the law, which is another pretty big one. So I don't know, I think what we're doing, I suppose, you try and stay close to the limit of what you're doing. I mean, as we're making more money from touring, I think we're putting more money into like things like the stage show and the whole kind of preparation and equipment and everything, so it's much more high quality than what it was when we started. So I'm trying to sort of make plans for the next tour. And there's like a couple of gigs that we're thinking of doing, a couple of big like 18,000 type arenas in the UK and France that we're playing, that we're thinking of doing something with a big choir and maybe an orchestra or something. But I'm thinking so much about those gigs, I'm scared I'm going to forget about the other gigs. Do you know what I mean? Because that's something we've never done before, like organising a mass with other people. I think it's a strange experience to try and coordinate or to try and be involved in a big thing. I mean, the experience that I got from playing with the orchestra on the two songs on the album is that it was the first time that I did feel the music was more than just me or more than just a band, you know. It felt like a shared thing, and I was looking around and I wasn't really sure who was in control. Like, everyone was kind of just doing their thing, and somewhere the music was being created, and like the producer was kind of just concentrating on the sound a little bit, and I was kind of trying to coordinate certain things, but I couldn't coordinate the orchestra. We had to get an arranger to coordinate them, and it's kind of this strange thing that happened that somehow a song appeared at the end. I think that's experience I like, because I've had so much kind of creative control for the first two albums, in terms of within the band. I think this band has definitely opened up much more to the other two band members. The music was much more of a collaboration in the band, in how the music was made, but also, you know, working with the orchestra, and also the producer Rich Cross, who we worked with, who did Mars Volta and stuff like that. Well, it's a feeling I've never felt before. I think it's a feeling of something like that. I don't know what it is. I think I've realised that in order to go on to do something that is truly great, you do have to collaborate. You know what I mean, I think if any individual tries to control too much everything around them, then it will never be something that is great, in my opinion. I think something I'm interested in for the future, but again, depends on certain constraints. So, well, the original idea can sometimes change during the execution of it. Like, you can have an original idea that takes you to a certain point, but when you start to try to deliver that, it changes. You change your reality. Maybe that's because of the constraints of reality, that you have to perceive it slightly differently or whatever. But I mean, it can be a good thing, you know. But you're saying which is the more important to me? I think that in the past it was probably the creation of it on the first album, second album. It's kind of the making the songs at home on my own, you know. But I think this album, it was more about the execution, you know, because it got to the point where some of the song ideas, whatever, were never going to truly be to work just within a three-piece band or within the reality of those instruments. So for that reason, I think that in this album I kind of I enjoyed the execution more, because it was a process of change from the original idea. That and luckily, I mean, the change was a good one. I mean, the songs came out maybe better or in a different form of what I thought the original idea was. I mean, the original idea, some of the original ideas you have for songs are is beyond even music. It's just a kind of a feeling or a complete visualization of colours and ideas or a feeling of something to do with the entire